Hi there, bit of an educational video for you today. We're going to talk about putters and how they can help you with your game. I've got a Wilson here, which is the ultimate blade, and then I've got the Odyssey 2 ball, which is a mallet. We're going to talk about the difference between blades and mallets, the pros and the cons, and how they can help you with your putting. But before I get into this video, do me a favour, click the like button, the subscribe button, so you don't miss out on any of our content with Golfalot. And answer me this question: do you play a blade or do you play a mallet putter? I think I know what the answer will be. These things, no one seems to use them anymore. I'm going to do a challenge today between the mallet and the blade putter. Six holes around the putting green at Stockport Golf Club, talking you through some of the aspects of these different heads. But actually, it's all about who wins. Who do you think's gonna win? It might not be as obvious as you think, because this putter, it reminds me of when I was a kid, when I used to play pitch and putt down the seafront at Cleethorpes. They used to give me one of these and I was pretty good. First up in the blade corner, it's the Wilson Staff 8802. Look at this beautifully milled head. There's nothing on it. There's no technology for me to tell you about. It's just a pure blade. There's not even a line. There's no insert. There's nothing. It reminds me of the old days. Jack Nicklaus over those putts like this. In fact, the last professional player I can remember using one really is Phil Mickelson. And he kind of dips in and out with it now. You don't see these at all. They used to be so popular. But a blade in irons for professionals still exists. But in putters, you hardly ever see it. And in the mallet corner, it's the Odyssey White Hot 2 Ball, one of the most famous putters of the last 20 years. Since the blade's gone, the mallet has certainly taken over. It's the putter that I use. Many of you will use at home in terms of this mini mallet, or nowadays you can get a maximum mallet as well. We see them on our TV screens. It's so often now that I can look on my TV screen and say, I'm using that putter. I don't really say it with irons, but I do say it with putter heads. It's packed with technology, weighting, inserts. There's a lot going on, even in the shaft. So I think this is a really good head-to-head between gorgeousness and softness and simplicity against all the technology. The first round of six holes, I'm going to be using the Wilson blade. Go. Can definitely feel the difference in strikes. So on that third hole, I didn't get it. I could feel it. That one there on the fourth, it felt middled. It went, thankfully it hit the hole actually, because that was a bit pacey. But there's a real difference between the good and the bad in this blade. Good feedback actually, but it doesn't help you out as much as I would have liked. The simplicity of this putter, it's quite nice to look down on. You know, I said at the beginning of the video how it's like Jack Nicklaus. I'm actually standing like him. I've gone conventional with my grip. I've opened my stance and I'm almost got that stabby strike to it. I don't know if it's because if you look here, the shaft's going in right at the back of the club, whereas with my two ball, it sits a bit different. There's no bend in this at all, is there? The lack of line, I think, does make it harder for me to center the ball on the face. I've got a tendency to put the ball in the toe, so I'm really trying to make myself set the ball out the heel. My stroke actually feels quite nice with it, because I'm not thinking, is it right? Is it perfect? Because there's no lines on the head. There's nothing to look at in the backswing like the two balls that I have on my Odyssey. So it frees it up. The stroke is certainly freed up because of that. Right then, Shall we see if I can hold one? That is such a good roll. Sit. God. Do you know what? The rolls on the last two holes have been great, but that was a bit fiery, wasn't it? Now these putts, I think, is where I might start to notice some difference overall. Maybe not on six holes, but if I was out on the golf course, you're going to leave yourself a couple of these at least around, aren't you? It's quite easy to turn this face. Right, come on. It's weird knowing that it's all down to you. You've got no help. Yes. Oh, I'm scared of that one. I can see why you fall in love and out of love with these style of putters, because when your confidence is on, they feel great. And when you're a little bit nervy, this length is awful. Oh, just that little tweak. So one over par with the blade. It's great. It's kind of like old school, but I feel like I'm making it far too hard for myself using this. Should you have a go with the two ball? Now for round two, six holes with the two ball. First impressions, it's like, what the hell am I looking at? The change between the blade to this is significant. And I think that was an issue for many people, especially me, actually, when I moved from an answer to looking at a mallet. I just hated it. It's almost, what is that? What is that? But things have changed so much, I think, in the last 10 years in terms of looks. We've seen TaylorMade make a white driver or a three wood, haven't we? We've seen red faces. Stuff is evolving. It's quite out there now with some manufacturers, and I think we're getting our heads around that. I mean, the spider putter, that was red at one point. It's not as big of a wow as it used to be. If we had this putter in the 70s, when the Wilson was kind of at the peak of its powers, I think everyone would have gone, no, 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 that is too fancy for me. Oh, this is so much softer than the Wilson, that insert. Hole two, must hit the ball harder. A lot more confidence over those smaller putts. Those two balls behind, I put the third one in front and it's just back and forth. It just seems a lot easier and a little bit less face rotation, which is what these mallets are about, really. There you go. I got the roll, but I also got the face angle, so it just stayed right on line. I've got the confidence of lining up the putt, because it's so much easier, and the weights just let the club swing through, keep the face square. That one rolled end over end. It never left the hole, actually. I started one online, I think, with the Wilson, just one. I started a lot more online with this Odyssey. Look at that one, bang online again, just needed hitting up the slope. It's not as fun with this. I mean, it is fun because you hold more, but it doesn't feel as like, I don't know, it doesn't feel as fun with the two ball. It feels a little bit easy. But that's what you want on the course, don't you? You want the easiness on the course. When you're on the putting green with no consequence, it doesn't really matter. And I think that's where this putter comes into its own. When there's a consequence to the outcome, you're a little bit nervous, hands might be feeling a bit shaky, your brain might be saying, don't miss it. That's where this can really help you out. Oh, it's online again, hit it. One under par for the two ball, the mallet, one over par for the Wilson blade. We knew that, didn't we? You know, there's just a difference between them. In terms of, one looks really pretty, but it's a bit hard work. And the other one The looks aren't great, are they? But you get over it because it's the performance aspect and putting. I know it's an art, but the whole reason we want to be on that green, we want to be holding putts. That's it. Do we really care what it looks like? And I think that's the way we are now. The last thing we think about is the looks, where it used to be the first thing we thought about. The winner of the challenge is the Odyssey 2 ball. Kind of no surprises, but I spoke about why. Between these two heads, I think we're just seeing an evolvement of putters. This was what everyone used to use, this shape head, for years, for decades. And then it was almost like somebody said, I'd put with a spaceship, a saucepan, as long as the ball went in. And somebody looked at them and said, really? So it's not all about feel and looks, as long as the ball goes in the hole. And they were like, yeah, of course. Next thing you know, the mallet came out and everything changed. The technology in this, with the weight in, the size of it, the easier, the alignment, the inserts even. Things just moved really quite quickly with putters. Before it was almost like, well, yeah, if you're a good putter, you can use anything. Yeah, I get that. But if you're a bad putter, can you improve your putting? Yes, you can if you buy something with an enhancement to it. And I think if you're a bad putter and you use both of these, this one will always come out on top. If you're a good putter and you use both of these, the chances are that will still come out on top overall. I can't imagine standing over three footers to try and win your club championship, to beat your mates on a Saturday, to lower your handicap with this and holding as many as this. And that's what it's all about for me. So let's talk about price, by the way. You'd expect with all the technology packed into these mallets that this would be cheaper. Well, it's not. It's 370 quid. You can pick it up slightly cheaper in shops right now. And it's that because of the craftsmanship, the milled face. I talked about how the shaft goes so nicely into the head, the looks, the care that's been taken into it. There's no technology, it's all about the feel in this, but that is pricey, that is punchy. And the grip wasn't even palm straight. And I know it's a lambkin, but I want a better grip than that if I have got that goodness on the end. That doesn't replicate that. I'd like to see that changing. But if you guys who are watching at home, this video was just a showcase. You can get that bit more help with your putter, like you can with your driver, like you can with your irons. It's worth going into your pro shops and trying out a couple of different ones, because looks can be deceiving. We all need a little help sometimes, and I'll be sticking to my two ball. Thank you all for watching this video. If you want to check out my written review on golfalot.com, you can for this Wilson. And if you look into the archives, you'll see this two ball as well. Anyways, that has been the educational video. It's not all about reviews with Golfalot. We're here to help you with your golf and your purchasing. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again soon.